Party Part 102.1 FM, and now I'm going to turn it over to Judy, the Predator Patrol radio program. It's a test. It's going to be a good test. We're going to have fun. All right, here we go. Both those mics are on.
And me.
Oh, I forgot about Shorty. Yeah, it's Toast and Shorty, the Toast and Shorty show. And what was your name again?
Lori. Lori, she's with Predator Patrol, too.
Yeah, so she can pick up the mic and talk into that. All three of them are on. There's a thing. You remember when you're ready to put the music back up? Just hit that play button and it'll come back. I recorded this for you.
You're the best.
Come on, dog. Wait on. Be a nice doggy.
Hello, everybody. We're going to have an exciting show tonight. This is going to be one of our little test shows, and tonight our topic is going to be the little girl Cherish that was kidnapped and murdered in Jacksonville, Florida by a gruesome child molester by the name of Smith. I'm not even going to give him a first name because he doesn't deserve any recognition. You remember that story last week?
I do.
Yeah, what do you think about it?
It makes me sick.
It is sick.
Yeah, it is.
Actually, we were sitting at home and it came across the news and it just made me sick to my stomach. Mm-hmm. Craig and I were talking about it and it was just, you know, being a mother of many children.
Many? How many do you have?
Six.
Oh, that's all?
Yeah.
That's
okay.
I raised nine, though. But, you know, it's beyond me being a single mother working two jobs. Never.
I know. Well, do you know the whole story?
I partly know it, not the whole story.
Well, you know, the way that this began, from what I gather, is that the mother took her three children, two little boys and her eight-year-old daughter, to the dollar store shopping. Some man started a conversation with the kids. The mom was shopping. Mom came up, became a part of the conversation. And in the discussion, mom had to cry about her past of being poor, homeless, not having things for her children, and even began to tell this douchebag that her little girl wanted to go visit her father and didn't have a dress to wear. So this guy says, hey, I have Walmart gift cards. I'm going to meet my wife at Walmart. Let's go to Walmart. I'll buy your kids some clothes. This mother allowed her three children to get in the van with this man, not even knowing him, not even knowing his last name, not knowing where he lived, nothing. Put her children in his van. And she followed. Yeah. She followed him to Walmart to go shopping. While they were in Walmart, the guy, guy doesn't even sound right. You know, the douchebag monster said he was hungry and took Cherish, the eight-year-old little girl, to the inside McDonald's. And that was the last anybody ever saw or heard of Cherish until they found her dead, mutilated body behind a church. So, mothers.
Behind a church.
Behind a church. This is like Carly Brucia's story.
Yeah.
You know? Carly Brucia was left behind a church. You know, what, did these guys go stand at the church after they got done murdering the little girl and ask for forgiveness?
Never happened.
Not in my book.
Well, the thing about it is he'd been out of jail for a month for prior
new charges.
Yeah.
In 1993, he was sent to prison because of child pornography. There was three victims. Went to prison, got out of prison, and he had eight or nine other charges between then and now. And his pending charges that he had was posing as a DCF worker. He was posing as if he was a worker from the welfare. And he met a woman and said that he needed to talk to her daughter to do an interview, and the mother caught on to it and didn't let her daughter go with this douchebag. But you know what? If this mom had have given in, this little girl probably would have been a murdered one as well. So he did get arrested. Those were his pending charges.
Who literally hands her children over to someone they just met? I don't care if you don't have a new dress or you don't. And now she doesn't even need a dress. Okay?
I know, right?
I mean, where's the rest of the children? Are they back with her for her to handle?
I have no idea. I don't know. I do believe the mother did get custody of her children. I mean, after all this has happened. But in my book, this mother committed a horrible crime, and I think that there should be some repercussions for this mother.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I seriously, yeah. really, really, I mean, just like the...
Or do you think that the guilt enough is punishment for her?
No.
Do you think that now she has to live with the guilt of what she did and what she could have done, but now what she could have done is too late?
No, because to begin with, it tells me a lot about her when she'd hand three kids to a man she doesn't even know for a new dress mm-hmm. or a new outfit or whatever. I'm not feeling it at all.
Yeah, I know. I'm not either.
No pity at all.
No pity party for mom.
Be a law passed, just like the Kaylee Anther. What is it? Anthony.
Oh, yeah. Casey.
Yeah. Anthony. Well, my child's been missing for a month with a babysitter that didn't even exist.
Right, right.
And even though she was found clear of the charges, which is BS, in my book. Yeah. There's no, I mean.
Well, you know what? There is no proof of negligence. We can assume there was negligence. We can assume that something that she was irresponsible about caused the death of her daughter. But you know what? Even the court of law never even discovered how this little girl died. There wasn't enough evidence. There are no witnesses. So how can you prosecute somebody for negligence, child abuse, when you don't even know the story? Nobody came forward. Casey Anthony kept her mouth shut. Her father didn't speak. The mother didn't speak. So now we have a dead child, and nobody knows how she died. Her body was so deteriorated and in that garbage bag that they couldn't even determine her cause of death. But so what do you charge the mom with?
For a month, and you're out getting tattoos and partying, and no, nothing's even said about it?
I agree.
I remember a couple times while my children were growing up, I always took my kids to school and picked them up.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you that, till they were old enough to even drive, and I was still.
Well, you know what? Your kids are the fortunate ones.
And a couple times, like an after school thing that was going on or something, I'd be late, or I'd be like, oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm.
I would beat myself up over it for days that they even had to sit there for 15 minutes. And they're like,
well, you know what? Not everybody has a good parent like you. Not everybody has a good parent like me. There's parents out there that are irresponsible, that don't deserve to have children, number one, that do not know the rules in life. They don't know that there's monsters out there. And if they do, they have that mentality that'll never happen to me.
We were at the store the other day. We pulled in the store, Craven and I, and we looked over, and the windows were down, and the mother was inside the store, and there was, I think the child was probably maybe 3 or 4, and then there was a baby in the seat, and they were in the car by themselves.
And did you call the police?
No. Because I didn't even notice. We went in, I didn't even notice it till we came out, and I looked over and I said, are those kids alone? I did call the police when two people left their dogs in the car at Walmart.
Oh, really?
But, I mean, yeah, I need to probably get more involved, but it's just everywhere you go.
Well, you know what? If everybody says, oh my God, look at that, there's kids left in the car. And then you go about your business, you don't do anything about it. Don't you think that maybe you're just as responsible as that parent for not doing something about it?
Let me tell you something that happened to me. I stopped at Family Dollar to get cat food. This was a few months ago.
Uh-huh.
It's down on Kennedy, down towards downtown. There's a little baby just barely walking with a diaper on and no shoes, walking around the store crying, following mm-hmm. me around. So finally I picked her up. Mm-hmm. I'm walking around the store. I'm going, where's the mother? Where's the mother? Where's the parents?
Right.
They were in the sock section. I was over in the cat food section. If anything knows.
So that was the other side of the store.
Right. And when I found the mother and the father, they jerked the baby up, and they treated me. And then two girls came up to me with brass knuckles on and said, you know what these are for? Because I picked up that child and tried to find where that child belonged.
Jeez.
I left my cat food and everything and just walked straight to my truck and left. Mm. Serious
Damn.
Business.
See, in that kind of situation, I would have probably went to the store manager. But then again, what's the store manager going
to
do?
Yeah, they stood there. I went up to try to talk to them, and this little...
Well, like I said, there's parents out there that like that do not deserve to have children. The parents who are not going to watch their child and set them free and think a store is a playground for their children, you got a problem.
Right.
And Teresa's got a great heart. Teresa loves children, or she wouldn't be here with me doing this show. And those parents out there who don't have the time for your kids, and you want to pawn them off on other people, and you want to send your kids to the park without supervision, and send them to the mall, and go out and do all these things without parental supervision, shame on you.
That's right. Or drop them off at the pool.
Yeah, talking about pools. Talking about pools, Teresa. What about Sulphur Springs City Pool?
Right.
You know how many sex offenders are at that pool?
Oh, a lot.
You know, last year we did a little sex offender search. Sulphur Springs City Pool is where all the children in Sulphur Springs go to in the summertime. There, last year, was 620 registered sex offenders within 5-mile radius of the swimming pool. Guess what? We did a search the other day because I was on Channel 13 doing a story about the little girl in Jacksonville, and I pulled up the registry. There's now 780 registered sex offenders within 5 miles of the Sulphur Springs City Pool, and it's summertime.
Where they all drop their children.
Within 5 miles. Do you know, in Hillsborough County, we have 1,100 square miles. And within that 1,100 square miles, we have over 1,200 registered sex offenders. That's one sex offender per mile, if not more. What about within 5 miles? 780. Think of the square footage. I mean, that has to be every other house, wouldn't you think?
Right. Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Every other house. You go through the registry and you see 9th Street, 10th Street, 11th Street, 12th Street, 13th Street, 14th Street, Brooks, Mulberry. I mean, it just keeps on going down. And you know what? That's the order that the streets are. And there's a sex offender on every street. There's 3 and 4 sex offenders that live in one house. There's a place on Nebraska that has 25 sex offenders in one house.
So let me ask you, like, if we were out and we were hanging out and we see something going down that's not right and we take it in our own hands, what happens?
No, we don't take it. We don't take law in our own hands.
When it comes to them?
Well, you know what? Don't put me on the spot. What goes on? Yeah, I know, right? No, you know what? You know what? We do have a judicial system. And if we're going to go out and if we're going to be victims advocates for the children, we have to be a role model. We have to do the right thing. We need to turn these guys over to law enforcement. But you know what? Nowadays, you got to do the legwork because they have had so many budget cuts and budget butts. That they can't keep up with all these guys.
No, that's what I'm saying. Say we were in a situation where we had to intervene and it got ugly.
Well, then we would have to intervene. Yeah. It depends on the situation. If we're if we see a little child getting molested or in the process of an abduction, hell yeah. Don't think that we're not going to interact. Can we shoot them? Is that what you're doing? Are you like, Teresa's here using a gun saying, can we shoot them? Well, if you have a concealed weapons permit and you fear for your life or the safety of another that's in your environment, then yes, you go bang, bang. Yes.
All right. That's,
no, don't I mean, that's just my opinion. I'm not telling you to go shoot sex offenders.
No, but
it is my opinion that if we come about a situation and there's a sex offender that's doing something horrible and we have to save a child's life, then hell yeah, I'll go to court as a witness and testify for you get off on those charges.
Well, you know,
So Teresa's not carrying a gun. There's going to be bullet holes all over Sulphur Springs and it may not be just sex offenders. Clear the road. Here comes Teresa. She's got a gun.
Yeah.
We're joking. That's all fun, guys. But no, you know, what we do is when we do take to the streets, we take photos of sex offenders into the neighborhoods. We let the neighbors know that a sex offender is in their area. And not only that, but we give them safety tips for the kids. It's all about awareness, you know. I mean, if people are aware, if you like a pit bull, you know, if you tell somebody, hey, don't go across that fence over there. There's a pit bull. People aren't going to go over there, right?
Right.
Unless they're stupid.
Unless they're, yeah. Just
so, you know, it's all about safety. It's all about education. Education on safety, prevention, and intervention. And that's what we're all about. You know, we have two parts to our organization. We have Safety Zone, which is the soft side, educating the kids, having safety rallies, doing fingerprinting. Then we have Predator Patrol, which is the bolder side that's more for the adults to go out and have fun and like, you know, go after child molesters. So,
I'm in.
100%?
I've been in.
You got both feet in?
Yeah.
Got your tennis shoes on?
Oh, no.
You got your underwear on right?
Absolutely not.
No. I didn't think so.
Probably not even mine.
I was wondering what happened to my granny panties.
We won't say whose they are, but...
Oh, jeez. Oh, man. Jeez, that's funny. So anyway, back to child molesters. Everybody keep an eye out on your kids. Keep an eye out on the neighborhood kids. Keep an eye out on your boyfriend. Keep an eye out on your grandpa and your teachers and your preachers and all those other people out there who are potentially child molesters. Just because you love the man that you're dating doesn't mean that he's not a bad guy.
That's right.
Got to keep your eyes open.
Check your doors. Be aware of your surroundings, your home, everything, all the time.
Yeah, make sure you wear panties every day.
And they don't have to be yours.
Oh, I wear mine. Oh, I'm not gonna wear somebody else's underwear. You wear his. Man, his panties got to be awful big.
Nah.
Well, you wear them on your head. You wear them as like suspenders, or you have to wear like suspenders with them, right? Like the coveralls, and you know, you wear rainbow stripes with them.
He's not listening to us.
Yeah, he's not listening. He's playing with his cords. I mean, playing with the cords.
He's listening. It's all in fun, honey. You know I'm just kidding.
We love you. We know your underwears are holy. They really are. Craven wears holy underwear. That's on his wish list. Underwear. Polka-dotted bikinis.
I think he wants to be left out of this one.
Yeah, all right. So,
sorry,
anyways,
honey.
So, you know, it's all about the kids. It's all about safety. It's all about us being aware. It's all about us coming together. And I tell you what, we got a strong biker community out there. And you bikers out there, you stand up and you take your place. We got an army out there. And we're going to take on these child molesters. We have zero tolerance. So if there's a child molester listening to our show, beware.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. So, well, Teresa, I think it's about time to play some music.
All right. Talk about next week, our show next
week. Oh, next week. All right. So let's forget the music for right now. We'll play some music in a minute. We have a lot of events coming up, guys. We have actually on the 20th is Craven's birthday party at the Radio Bar and Grill. He needs underwear. Size 32. Oh, wait. 42.
No.
22. Long. Oh, no, that's just in jeans. I'm sorry.
Don't buy him underwear. He'll get pissed. I'll buy underwear.
Oh, you can buy the underwear? I'll buy him underwear. I don't mind buying him underwear. Big Lots has a great... I mean, you can get them for really cheap there. Anyways, okay, so Craven's birthday is on the 20th here at the Radio Bar and Grill. Everybody come and have a good time. On the 21st, we are having a serious ride. Laura Lucky. Somebody that's very close to my heart. She's actually my sister-in-law. About 2-3 months ago, she was diagnosed with cancer. It's already progressed to stage 3. She has to have a double mastectomy done, but they will not remove her breast until she gets through her chemo and radiation. It's been really tough on her and my brother. She's self-employed, therefore she had no insurance, and she has the type of work that's very labored, and she's been unable to work. So our family's been kind of helping out. So we're going to reach out to the community, see if you guys will come and join us for some fun. Poke a run. We're going to take a nice long ride, come back for spaghetti and salad and some cold beer. Have a little auction, Chinese raffle, 50-50. And then we are going to have Safety Zone. Predator Patrol is going to be doing a march through Sulphur Springs doing sexual predator notification. And we would love to have more volunteers to come out. Leave your weapons at home. This is an educational day. The date is the... I forgot. Maybe it's the 28th. It's on a Sunday. I think it's the last Sunday in July. Yep, 28th. So then August 4th, we are going to be doing another event. That is going to be our Predator Patrol biannual poker run. another long ride, and this is going to be raising funds for Predator Patrol. We need tents, and we need more safety items. We're running low on inventory. So that will be our ride on the 4th of August. Then we are also going to do a safety rally on that event. The items that we're going to be purchasing from that, we're going to take to the streets in Sulphur Springs, and we're going to do a safety rally with a bouncy house. We're going to have fingerprinting. We're going to take snacks out for the kids and just make it an educational day. This is a free event to Sulphur Springs. We're still trying to figure out a date, but it is going to be in August. It's going to be a back-to-school safety rally, and we will need volunteers for that. So it's going to be a busy July, a busy August, but it's all going to be fun. It's all going to be for a good cause. So hopefully you guys can join us. Mark it on the calendar. We'll post it on our Predator Patrol Facebook page as well. Please feel free to do a friend request for the Radio Bar and Grill, and also do a like, and same with Predator Patrol.
Also on the 21st, we'll have more information throughout this next couple weeks in August 4th. The poker run and benefit will start at Radio Bar and Grill, and yep, it will also end at Radio Bar and Grill.
Absolutely.
And we take any donations, anything you'd like to do. Just get a hold of Judy.
Definitely.
Or whatever.
Yeah, we're going to start at Radio Bar and Grill. Teresa's already promised Bloody Marys. And also some sort of breakfast. It may be bread and butter, but as long as it's food in our belly, we're happy. And then we're going to end here. We'll decide on what kind of food we're going to have on the Predator Patrol. But for the Laura Lucky ride, it will be a spaghetti dinner. Come suck some noodles with us. Lori.
Slurp them noodles.
Oh, goodness. All right, guys. Well, thanks for listening and watching, and you know, thanks for your support. It takes an army to go out there and knock these child molesters down. And thank you guys for standing up and fighting for us.
Thank you, Judy.
Peace out.
Bye.
Bye. Bye don't sound right. You don't end the show by saying bye. Until next time.
Next Sunday from 7 to 9.
7 to 9, next Sunday, is our show.
Short toast.
I don't read sign language. Can you please speak louder?
Short toast?
I don't know. Somebody's doing sign language to the glass, and I don't understand it.
No, it's not Dubai. It's laters.
Oh, laters. Okay, later gators.
I always say peace.
Yeah, Therese always says peace.
On the flip
side, she says peace.
I'm all about peace.
I like peace signs.
I like peace.
I like peace and peace signs.
Like to get a piece.
I don't ever get a piece,
too,
but
you know.
Oh, we were thinking the same, weren't we?
Yeah.
What does a piece feel like anymore?
Really good.
Oh, does it really?
Yeah.
What color is it?
Pink.
Oh, pretty color. Just as long as it's not blue or gray.
Perhaps it's horse.
Oh. Goodness gracious. All right, this is supposed to be about the kids and about Predator Patrol, but we're getting a little dingy here.
Yeah, well, we got to have fun. And
I know.
It's our first one.
We'll it's a serious issue, but we got to have fun educating. You know, education could be fun.
So next Sunday, starting from 7, that's our first show. And from
7 to 9.
Yeah, and what are we calling it?
Predator Patrol Programming. Unless we want to put Predator Patrol Pirate Programming.
With
Toast and Juicy. No, wait. What's your name? Sorry. Toast and the little bus. Shorty. Shorty. Okay, I'm sorry. Toast and the bus. No.
Short toast or toast short? I don't know.
How about
that out.
Toast and Shorty in the morning? Wait, we're not in the morning, are we?
In the evening.
Oh, in the evening.
Honey,
Shorty and Toast in the morning. In the evening.
Because you're really good at that, figuring out things and words and punctuation and writing and all that stuff.
All right, so tune in, guys. We're going to have a great show. We're going to have special guests. We're going to be bringing in a probation officer who did sex offender monitoring for like 20 plus years. We're going to bring in other people who have been molested and have success stories to tell. We may even bring in a sex offender to tell his story. But you know what? The good part is he's not going to make it out of here.
Definitely not. Enter at your own risk.
Yeah, that's right. We need the sign on the door. Enter at your own risk. Yeah. So anyways, we're going to have a great show. I'm really excited. I'm just really excited having Teresa and Craven working with me. It's been an honor having them as my friends. I've known both of them for many, many years, and it's funny how we come back to a full circle with our friends, you know?
We were just saying that. He was saying how he'd, recorded for you and got in on some things, and you all have been friends for a while, and I have worked with you years ago, and then now all of a sudden we're all three together.
So. I know, isn't that funny?
It was a journey already planned.
Craven and I had like a love-hate relationship. It's hard to explain, you know?
A lot of people have that with them.
Yeah, I know, but ours was really like a strange relationship. It's like, do I get a hug this time, or am I going to get a fuck you? Oh, wait, can we say that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he always does.
So, I do love Craven. I've always loved Craven.
He's badass.
Yeah.
I love him, too.
Yeah, but I love him in a different way, Teresa. I'd never go to bed with him.
I try not to get out of bed.
I don't know what he said. It don't matter. It ain't his show. No, really. Don't you start nothing.
Oh, yeah.
I ain't even never kissed that man.
That's really nice.
Does he even have a pair of lips behind all that hair?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
On which body part?
So anyways, yeah, Teresa's nice, very close honey. To my heart. Teresa has been a strong supporter throughout the years. Teresa and I, our friendship has always been there. You know what? Friendship is not based on the quantity of time, it's the quality of time. And we've had a lot of good times together. And Teresa has even come to our Predator Patrol meetings. She helped us put together one of our Predator Patrol poker runs and did a magnificent job. So I really look forward to not only having them as my friend, but also having them as a part of our Predator Patrol.
You got it, girl.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you, Craven.
And my honey out there. He's good too.
Yeah, I think he's in. You know what? I tell you what. One of the craziest things with Craven, he was so into going after these child molesters. He had that camera in their face. He was like all balls to the wall.
Yes, sit down, honey. He was just somewhere. Telling me that story too.
Somewhere. There's like taping of this. Oh, there my is. God, there's that's the camera. Camera. Holy cow. Do you still have that tape when we went over to that house?
Yeah,
you do?
Wow,
that would be really cool to play that back. We went into a child molester's, not child molester, Kevin Kinder, the guy who kidnapped my son, was actually using an address saying that that's where he lived, and he really didn't. But he was in there molesting this mentally challenged 19-year-old boy, used the guy's name for credit, was like really raping him like viciously, violently. And Craven and I went into this house, and Craven and I interviewed this family and got enough information for the courts to turn it over. And Kevin Kinder got violated on his probation, but the judge just slapped him on the wrist and let him go. So
it's funny. He brought that camera here, the video camera, and we were riding home, and he was telling me the story.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. And on another day, Kevin Kinder was registered at a hotel on Nebraska. And it was called Orange Hotel. And Habu Dali was running that place. I don't remember his name. Maybe it was a Patel. I don't know. I think it's called Abu Dali, right? Abu Dali Patel?
He calls it Habib.
Habib. No, Habib means like baby. That means like baby. Anyways, so the guy says Kevin Kinder wasn't there. And I said, yes, he is. He's registered. And I showed him the registration and said, here he is. And this guy even went and unlocked that door because he saw a line of black and white and he was scared.
And Craven was with you.
Yeah, Craven was with me. There was several guys with us that day. But the guy opened up the door and Kevin Kinder was not there. And there was no evidence of anybody being in that room. So Kevin Kinder had packed up and moved out. And that's where he got a violation of probation, failure to register. So, yeah, we've got some memories. Craven's been he's been there for us, you know, back in the day. So.
And he's totally, yeah, he's in.
So here we are. We're at it full force, guys. We got both our feet in, and we got our uniforms on, and we're ready to go.
I'll tell you what. I wouldn't want to mess with him on this either. Or you or I.
No. Why would anybody want to mess with us? But they're, you know, people are just stupid. Some people do. Anyways, guys, peace out. Thank you for listening. And we will be back next Sunday from 7 to 9. And we will have some exciting stories and some good music. Remember. Radio Bar and Grill, come in for a cold beer.
Keep an eye on your children.
Absolutely.
Both eyes.
Definitely. Night. Good night.
Good night.
You didn't put the music on.
Wanna get rocked? Away, he says, he got plans for me.